So you've arrived in Bangkok, and one of the highlights of your stay is surely going to be eating Thai food. But there are thousands of restaurants and other eating establishments to choose from just in this city. How will you know if they're any good? How will you even know if the food you're given is authentically Thai?
This could be one of the best places to start. Jay Phi has been called the Mozart of the wok. There's nothing fancy about her little restaurant in Bangkok's historic quarter, but her cooking is often praised as some of the finest in the city.
Jay Phi is a child of my grandma's time. 5-60 years ago, Jay Phi was a child who would cook the rice. Gathi would be cooked with her hands, she would share the gathi.
This is her signature dish, the classic sour Thai soup, Tom Yam Goong, cooked quickly on a ferocious fire. Herbs and spices flung in almost instinctively. It's a dish you can find all over the world, but usually rather poor imitations.
Tom Yam Goong.
Hong Di Makap, Koko Makap. Now that is supposed to be the finest Tom Yam Goong you can get anywhere in Bangkok. It's very sour, very spicy, intense flavours. The question is, can it pass the Thai taste robot test?
Yes, a tasting robot. Developed with government money, this box of sensors and processors can detect whether a dish has the right balance of aromas and flavors. What we want.
ของอาหารไทยในต่างประเทศเนี่ยมักจะไม่เหมือนอาหารไทยแท้ๆแล้วเราอยากรู้ว่ารสชาติอาหารไทยแท้ๆเนี่ย
We gave it a sample of Jay Phi's powerful Tom Yam soup. But would it pass?
Tom Yam Goong.
90%.
Is that good?
Yes, very good.
This was the best score any Tom Yam Goong has got until now. So the taste robot does seem to know a thing or two about good food.But then, who is to say what is the right standard for Thai cooking? This is Pad Thai, one of the country's most popular dishes. Yet it was invented just 70 years ago, and already comes in many delicious variations. No robot can hope to impose uniformity on this messy, creative process. Jonathan Head, BBC News, Bangkok.